interesting point. So, and we actually tell towns to do it that way. You know, this way you have all of your data. You don't even have to make a final determination. If you went out to RFP and we were fortunate to be selected, you would not have to make a final determination about which business model you want to use until you are approved by DOT and you've had a chance to really crunch the numbers. And we tell towns to do that. I gave you a real life example because, again, the highest rate of return for the municipality is on a fixed fee. And the reason for that is because the volume is so extraordinarily high. If you wind up choosing a tier-based model, we wind up making more money right now.
How many companies are there?
There are about four
in the state.
In the country.
In the country.
Yeah.
The country.
Yeah. Our chief competitor is Redflex. They're a good company, but Charlie's better than them. They have 7 clients in New Jersey, and we have 18.
Are they equal to your price?
No, I shop them on a pencil each and every time. So, actually, through economy of scale, our prices are now lower than when they were when we started. So, if you went out to a bid, you'd have one of the lowest prices. Yeah.
If we went the $19,000 per intersection round, and we want to make the $19,000, maybe $18,000. What prohibits us from then going to a price per ticket, or that we bring in something?
Nothing other than the contractual limitations. So and there are instances where we provide a provision in place that, you know, somehow you change your mind. I will tell you again, it obviously has to do with the level of risk that the municipality wants to take. And again, we just as the chief had indicated, we want you to make the most informed decision. So it makes sense to quantify the numbers and then cut your numbers in half so that you really know what makes sense.
What's the standard length of contracts?
5 years. Yeah. Yes, Captain.
It might sound like a dumb question, but any of these municipalities have these cameras posted on a light station where there's dual jurisdiction? Like Knickerbocker Road.
Sure.
Shared with Cresco.
Sure. Well, as you know, you have curb to curb. So we are.
Well, it really doesn't work that way sometimes.
Yeah,
so.
Okay,
the
good.
Yellow line.
That's one of our accidents we get
quick. You might want to curve to curve that one.
Well, I will tell you that this town, there's a town over here next to the Hacktop, it's called Greenwich. And the councilman and the governing body in Greenwich had an epiphany once they realized how much revenue was coming in. They have one of the approaches there at that intersection, and they don't want there to be a curb-to-curb anymore. They want a piece of that revenue. So it's hard to say how it's going to ultimately happen, but there's a real-life example of it. Right now, all the revenue is going to Viacom. And that is a bifurcated jurisdiction right there. Did I explain the business model, the pricing? It's fairly complicated. Yeah, it's hard for me to show without seeing real data, but again, I will tell you that it's always contractually revenue neutral. We'll never go into your pocket. We install, we operate, and we maintain for the life of the contract and provide a level of service to the thing.
Well, that was quite informative.
I hope so.
It's quite a good question. I sound like you
really have. Yeah, I tell you what, it's a good lively group again.
I agree. So, regardless of the income, after a period of time, so is the book time.
That's correct.
Yep. And
that's in writing.
Okay, well, I think at this point we'll have further discussion internally, and we'll reach out to you for either more information or to obviously on the RFPs.
Thank you, Mayor. Certainly appreciate your time with members of the governing body. Thank you so much.
Thank
you. Public, again, certainly appreciate your time tonight and look forward to working with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Question for Craig. What would be the next steps with this? Would we have the motion to go out for an RFP?
Resolve to issue an RFP. I think, though, we want to take this fired up on his offer to study, provide some data so you have an idea of what you're doing with. Both for your internal fiscal and police department purposes, as well as the public relations. Exactly. If we want some of the papers, we get a little bit of background. I would say that from a procedural standpoint, if the chairman could want to proceed with raised issue in an RFP, I think we want to, whether it's ABS or one of the competitors have studied on it, and no cost, just check, and then issue the RFP, get all the data, see who's got what, what the various, you know, pricing models and other various variations are, and then maybe make a decision you want to proceed with the program, top of the program, enact the ordinance, and go to the DOT, very well, and the customer.
So is there any official action that we need to take tonight to do this study?
I think what you want to do is authorize the study to resolve to authorize the study. Once it's no cost, I think you can do that without, authorized John and formal. There's no money being spent.
We don't have to do the survey.
No, I think you can, as a group, with the mayor, as chief executive of the department, construct the administrative plans for complementing the study.
So from an administrative, like procedural perspective, if you got the study, I'm just trying to think in terms of timelines for the budget, because if it's going to take 3 to 6 months sitting at the DOT.
Yeah, it sounds to me like you're probably not going to see an appreciable level in 2012. I mean, if you get the study done, and let's say, let's be pessimistic, and your first reading is in April, and we can the second meeting in April, the 20-day stop period gets into May, and then, you've got your RFP process. Well, actually, no, the ordinance will be after the RFP at the point, or it could be simultaneous. You're mid-year before you get down to DOT, and then you'll take 3 to 6 months, or September to December. I mean, you're talking probably 2013 before you see it down. $1,000. I'd like to see it now, but it's something that the government body is trying to do, and it makes sense to do this in the
Is that a question for the council?
Yes, yes.
And part of it is, well, it's probably part of what you think about the budget. So, I mean, if we need that a month or two into this year,
and
we
need
to be looking at next year's budget, but with some kind of revenue to be able, we won't see anything. Water budget this year because
probably because then you got the 30-day warning period. Right. You're not setting real dollars. So any of those can be helpful, but
we open to the public. First by Councilman Garrett. Second. Does anyone in the audience have any questions in regards to resolutions on the non-consent agenda? Seeing no questions on the non-consent agenda. Those in public? First of Council Carr. Second of Council Freeman.
Councilmember Jacoby?
Yes.
Carr?
Yes.
Freeman?
Yes.
Hayes?
Yes.
And Chance?
Yes.
Non-consent agenda is number 72, appointment of Thomas Ciotti to the Ethics Board.
Mr. Mayor, I hate to do this again. I know we tabled it for this meeting. I want to speak to him. I did, and I know you attempted some other, another resume to play on this speech this morning, and I really haven't had a chance to review it.
Can I make a motion to table this?
Please.
Motion by Councilwoman Chancey to table this for this meeting. Second.
I'll second that.
I'll second by Council Freeman.
And then, Mr. Mayor, as a liaison to the Ethics Board, I think we should move on it because they can't meet that on the floor. So we should try to get this resolved. I don't think we should be able to table now. Excuse me? I mean, we don't want too much of this. So I think we have to put some amendments in the way. The only way we just, it wasn't operational. That's all I was saying.
Well, let's see if the motion to table this passed. And I don't know.
Okay.
Councilmember Jacoby?
Yes.
Carr?
Yes.
Yes.
Freeman?
Yes.
Hayes?
Yes.
And Chance?
Yes.
This moment, I get the administration's report.
Thank you, Mayor. I'll do this quickly. The Swinboro remediation construction is going very well. We had a site meeting that was extremely informative for Mayor, Councilman. Our parish and councilwoman's on a Janice were on site. The weather's been really nice, so they've been working very, very quickly. I was down there again today. And the way things are going, unless we have some major weather issues, they should be coming in a timely fashion. The energy efficiency conservative block grant program that I was speaking about, the clean energy program, we had a savings of $93,000 to the borough. All three firehouses are in the process of being done now, and the library equipment will be delivered within the next week, and they can be done within this month. And then all four sites will start to realize savings in their energy. Phase two pre-construction meeting was held. I want to thank TNF for facilitating that. The work of utilities is one concern that we have with some of the potential conflicts on both water and gas, and we're working through T&M and the contractors, so we have no impact on the taxpayers of Dumont for those conflicts. The Dumont PBA will be hosting a beefsteak with entertainment on June 1st in Bergenfield. If anybody on the mayor council is interested in attending that, please let me know. We'll set that up. DPW requested the hiring of the seasonals to begin on March 26th. In the past, we brought in six seasonals. This year, we're only bringing in four. As savings, they'll be starting to get the parks ready for
people's backyards. We want to become more as friendly and as approachable to the people as we can. So I think we feel that Greg is a great person to handle the project. He also has the experience of doing the phase one drainage project. The old contractors, he's been with us for 5 years now, and he's been just great as an inspector. As Mr. Burke said, we had a pre-construction meeting last week for the phase two project. This week they're going to start installing safety surface to delineate their work, and soon after they're going to start clearing. They're aware that we just posted up the overall project schedule for the project, and they will be submitting 2 week schedules weekly just to give us the update